Hey everyone, it's Andy, and I'm here with my coworker Olivia, and today we're going to talk through a tutorial on using Symbology in ArcGIS Pro.
We already have the data we need to make an informative map of public transportation as it relates to the population in Christchurch, New Zealand. To get the full story from the data, we'll use a variety of options to symbolize each layer.
Right now our map is displaying the extent of Christchurch's urban area, but it's covering our area of interest. The Symbology Gallery contains some pre-configured options that can save us some time and effort. Let's try this transparent extent indicator.
That's already looking better.
I'm going to add our donut effect to the symbol, which will give us a natural emphasis on the border of the layer.
And let's change the base map too. The light gray base map is less detailed, and it'll help keep the focus on the bus routes, which we'll add in a little bit.
Since we already know we are in Christchurch, I'm going to remove the base map's reference layer.
There are quite a few bus stations in Christchurch. Does the gallery have a symbol for bus stations?
Yep, and we can customize it by changing the color. I'm going to go with this Cabernet. Any changes you make to a symbol can be previewed before they are applied to the map. Let's zoom in here.
We should change the outline of the symbol to Cabernet too.
There, that's much better.
Each layer in our map can have a visibility range. This is particularly useful when your map has several layers. Let's set a visibility range so that the bus stops don't appear if the scale is out beyond 1 to 24,000.
Now they no longer appear, and that's expected at this scale. When we adjust the scale to look at the map closer, they'll reappear.
Another thing we want to show in this map are the bus routes themselves.
There are different types of buses used for public transit. In the attribute table of the layer, we can see the four types used in Christchurch.
Let's modify the symbology and symbolize the layer by these unique values.
I'm going to choose this minor road symbol to serve as our base that we can apply a color scheme to. Since there are only four types, let's choose a color scheme with only four colors.
That looks pretty good, except the ferry is orange and I would have expected a blue there.
Good call. Let's change the color on that one.
Nice. Now, what about that population layer?
Well, there are a lot of points here. Each point is representing the mesh block. At this scale, there are way too many points to make sense of, and we really don't need to see each individual point.
So in that case, let's symbolize the data as a heat map. That will aggregate the data from all those points and show us areas with the highest population.
Sure. First, we need to change the weight field from the count of total points to population. And we'll change the method, and to show more variation, modify the radius. The heat map is covering our bus routes, but with some transparency, we can see both of these very clearly.
Wow, that's a really nice effect. Thanks for showing us this. If you'd like to give this tutorial a try, head over to the ArcGIS Pro Help and follow along with the detailed steps.